Hi guys, is AI going to replace artists? The short answer is no, definitely not. Not even close at the moment. But the reality and the long answer is, if we as designers don't upgrade ourselves or open to the idea of AI and what it is all about, then eventually, yes. I'm not talking about far future here, guys. I'm not saying designers are going to be obsolete in the future either. But we will be if we ignore where the world is going with this. I know you guys are already thinking, what the hell? And I know you guys are already angry with me for doing the tutorial in AI. This is coming out from a designer, and already I can see a lot of you guys hating me for doing AI tutorials. But hear me out, guys, okay? Please give me a chance to explain this to you. This is my reason to do so. This is my reason to do the tutorials which I did. As designers, I'm sure all of us are very passionate about our work. That's the most valuable thing for us. Most of us enjoy doing what we are doing, and in return, we get paid to make a living. What else you want, right? If you are doing art as a passion, not to make a living from it, then you don't even need to worry about AI or anything. You can do what you are doing and continue to enjoy your work. I'm not talking for people who are doing art for passion. Okay? I'm talking for the people who are working as an artist or designers to make a living. Designers like me, we do design for others. Others find value in it for them, and they pay us money or salary in return to do the artworks for them. Okay? Most of us work for companies. We don't even own the artwork we are producing inside the company. They are only paying for us for the time we are spending inside the company. The value what they pay can be based on our skill levels or other factors. But basically, they are just paying for us for the time and efforts we are putting in that company. Where is this value comes from? Because I may think I'm worth $1 million per month. How do you measure that? Value is basically what someone is willing to pay for something. At the same time, someone is willing to take for something in return. Okay, simple as that. Now, I'm purely talking from commercial point of view in here. Yes, people who say art became commercial, that's the problem, blah, blah, blah. Again, we are making art to make a living. If you don't like commercial art, then who is going to pay for you, pay for us? How are you going to survive in this world? Let's think about for a moment, the guy who is paying your salaries, or even worse, the company or corporation who is paying us to do the work for them. Let's think from their point of view. Let me give you a very simple example to explain this, okay? This is true for any scale, but let's say you are working in a small web development company, all right? And your job is to create graphics for websites. As humans, we can probably, at best, at absolute best, if we spend 8 hours in a day, we can create maybe 5 artworks, which 3 of them can be perfect, 2 might be not so perfect. I'm talking about artworks from sketch, not photo manipulations or stuff like that, okay? And let's say there are 3 designers doing this. All 3 together, on average, they can produce 15 artworks. Just an average number, okay? And for this, company has to pay for 3 of you. And depend on where you're living, let's say average salary is 3K, company has to pay 9K for 3 of them. Plus the software's employment benefits and stuff like that, I just put another 1,000K. It's much, much more higher, but I'm just putting 1K for example in here. Company has to pay 10K for 3 designers, okay? With AI, take the Midjourney for an example. For the entire year, for unlimited ads with commercial license, they only need to pay $500. And with only one guy, a junior guy who doesn't need to be a senior guy in here, you just need to know how to use the software. They can produce, with one guy, they can produce 15 artworks less than 1 hour. And the works can be looked like it came out from a Pixar studio or something like that. What do you think the company will choose? Paying a junior level guy who is not a real designer, less than 3K, and with the software and everything, they can still save more than 60% of their original cost and 8 times more artworks per day. Most companies doesn't care about you guys. They only care about numbers. That's the reality we are living in. If you guys find a job where your company or your boss truly, truly care about you, then you are few lucky ones. This is not only for designers. This is for everybody. Content creators, writers, coders, and even lawyers. Why do you think mass layoffs are going all over the tech industry right now? Because companies now realize they can do more with less employees with AI. They are telling 1,000 different reasons for it, but this is the real reason. Trust me, guys. And the worst part is that this is going to affect the most seniors in every sector who has the most skills and experience. Reason is pretty simple. Reason is they are paid more. They can be now replaced with some junior guys with low salary who only need to know how to use the tools. Okay, how to use these AI tools. People who are saying I'm embracing AI, no, I'm not. Do I like it? Absolutely not. I hate AI. Is it even art? No, it's not. It's a joke. But guys, I got no other choice. There's no other way around. AI is here to stay whether we like it or not. So what can we do about it? We can't fight AI. It's not going to go away. Only way going forward is to learn the tools. With our creativity and the skills we already have, we can make absolutely great, I won't call it art, digital things, which now we call AI art. For now, at the same time, especially for senior designers, I'm telling, use other AI tools, which are coming out right now for our own good, for our own self, for ourselves, such as the ChatGPT, to build up something. Not for the employers, for us. Explore some passive income opportunities or build your own business. Don't rely too much on your employers because now it seems like if you have more skills, then you are not the person they want. Most of these companies want someone who knows how to use some basic tools. That's it. They are easy to control. And they are easy to dispose as well. Use your design skills and experience and try to use the new AI tools for your advantage to make a living. Or at least keep it as a backup option. There are already guys doing that. You can find lots of new opportunities since this is very new. Example, I even saw one guy made thousands of dollars using ChatGPT and AI tools to create illustration books and sold it on Amazon. Possibilities are endless, guys. We can sit down and complain or we can use the AI tools for our advantage. Now, we also don't need writers or content creators to do the thing for us. We use our design skills and use the AI tools to create other things for us. This AI tutorials, which I created in here, is specially designed for designers. Because most of the tutorials you see online is only showing how a non-designer will use an AI tutorial or AI tool to create art at the moment. It's like a person who never draw is showing how to drive a self-driving car, right? So this is my opinion. I will still continue doing my AI tutorials. At the same time, I will still do the AI, Adobe Illustrator and Photoshop and other tutorials as usual as well. Hope you guys understood my point. I'm sure some of you still hate me for what I'm doing.
you can have your own opinion, guys. You are entitled to have your own opinion. But as a person who is in this industry for many years, seeing the changes we went through, this AI, not only for designers, for most of us, is going to change the world. The world we live is going to be changed completely, especially the way we are going to work in the future. All right, guys, that's all about it for this video. And thank you guys for listening. And if you guys have other opinions or what you guys think about the AI, you guys can comment in the comment section below. See you guys in the next video.